What's up, YC?
Just a short time ago, they were in full roar as their guys burst out of the locker room. We're ready for football as the Bengals get set to do battle with the Pittsburgh Steelers. Here's Randy Bullock now to put toe to leather, and we are underway from Cincinnati. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
This shit ain't easy.
Fight forward to about the 27-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. A fake to Bell. Now it's Roethlisberger. The Bengal pressure gets him that time. Down he goes. Jordan Willis. He's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of 9.
Now Ben. Man, Stone Cold about to beat the shit out this boy.
And he connects with Vance McDonald. And he's gonna have the first down.
We got a mic.
35. It'll be a gain of 17 and a Pittsburgh first.
Can't be giving them up though, Stone Cold.
No.
Sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things
come. My first 3rd and 17.
My first game of the day. I'm a little rusty. I'm gonna wake up in a minute. Oh, he's one of them type of players. Okay.
Which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback who has to slide and find open space to throw.
On second down, Roethlisberger.
Oh, man. What the fuck?
That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be third down. I think defensively you're okay with that. Here in the first quarter, he's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch,
Now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
Fresh set of downs here. Out of the gun, it's Roethlisberger. This is Bell on the dump off. And he'll get it down at 47 here. It'll be a gain of 8 yards, and it's a second down. I don't think it's a surprise they're throwing the football early. We expected that. They told us they were going to come out firing, but 4 for 4 on the opening drive. They like that.
They don't just like it. They love it, because now everyone gets...
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Geno Atkins breaking through to get him for a loss of 7. On third down, Roethlisberger.
What the hell?
Finds McDonald. The passing game in rhythm right now for Pittsburgh. There's another first down.
I know where.
Pass experience. Before you actually play a game, you visualize what's going to happen. And I don't know anyone who doesn't visualize themselves being in the center of what's going on. That's 3 catches for him here in the early going. He's got to like the way this is starting.
Absolutely. 3 catches on any drive is good. Opening drive, that's a tone set. They'll throw on first down to Roethlisberger. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Pressure, and that's certainly going to be a key to this game going forward. And that time, they were able to get in there and influence the throw. Remember, quarterbacks got to get rid of it. They don't have the tuck roll that they can fall back on anymore.
Second and 10 as Roethlisberger once more. And they get to him with the pressure as Roethlisberger goes down. Carlos Dunlap in there to bring him down for a loss of 7. From the gun on third down, it's
come on, man.
Over the middle, complete. It's McDonald. 14 yards is the pickup there, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
He wasn't the primary target, but I think it was almost like a check down situation, wasn't it?
Yeah, hoping he can break
some of that. Man, come on.
Get into that big frame and hope he can scatter some bodies, unable to get it done.
The passing game in rhythm right now for Pittsburgh. There's another first down.
I'm not sure that this play was designed for him specifically, but they got through the progressions and got the ball to him. So, second catch on the drive. He may not be a primary guy, but they definitely want him involved, don't they?
Absolutely. This early, the opening drive, as you said, 2 catches. So, if they can get him going in the passing game, it should open up his running game, too. From the red zone now, here's Roethlisberger on first down. And he's got it.
Fine, no that shit. Come on.
Tackled down at the 1. Back to back nice plays. 12 yards that time and a first down. And the seemingly endless drive continues. And they'll turn to the power game to try to get in. And he's into the end zone.
Don't play me, some nice guy.
It's the fullback taking it in from a
little terrible defensive drive for me. Damn, I'm gonna block that motherfucker.
And he'll put it through to make it 7-0 Steelers.
Yeah. I'm fucking home.
Boswell on now to kick this one away. This is Field at the goal line. The decision to come out is going to cost him 5.
Hold on, bro. You start the clock.
Taken down
The former second round pick, this is Joe Mixon, and he'll take it ahead to the 28-yard line. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
Hey, Scott, what's the word on 19, yo?
I feel like he's going to have a pretty big game on the ground.
Yeah, you can tell early on he's got a little burst in his step, and that's a big pickup right there on first down.
Second down following the run.
Okay.
Can y'all send me FedEx?
And he's got the hookup to Brandon LaFell. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A very solid gain of 27. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. Now a play fake here on first down. Going deep downfield for Rolt. And he will take it on in for a Bengals touchdown. A big play there. 45 yards. And the Bengals are an extra point away from tying up this football game. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This is fielded at the goal line. Putting him a hat tip real quick, Charles, to J.J. Watt before the possession switches here. Walter Payton, NFL Man of the Year. They totaled up how much he helped raise for Hurricane Relief, $37
million. Incredible. Hurricane Harvey, which really hit the Houston area in a big way, and his original goal was $200,000. So congratulations to J.J. Watt and all the people who participated. And Greg Olsen of the Panthers, Benjamin Watson of the Ravens, both tight ends, also nominated and finalists for the most prestigious award as determined by the NFL, the Walter Payton Man of the Year Award.
He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. And this will probably be the last play of the quarter.
I'm taking my ass to bed. I'll let y'all tomorrow.
What the?
And it's a big play there as he is finally taken down on what will be a terrific final act of this first quarter.
Oh, okay.
So the offense has it first and 10. Roethlisberger got his man complete over the middle. That's McDonald. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
When you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
Come get the nigga, bro. God damn. That three tackle we missed.
Fucking go. Love this three down.
And the Steelers have taken the lead. And they're able to run it in. It started with a battle in the trenches. They won there. And they got in for 6 points.
And that's going to be a tough one for the defense to deal with. They've got to go to the bench now and figure out how we're going to slow down this running game. Because on that particular play, they had
one
no answer.
One second. One second. One second.
This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Charles, we got a second here to discuss Cincinnati as their offense works their way back out there. And Marvin Lewis, many thought on the way out, but now a 2-year extension, and it's 2 straight years without them being in the playoffs after 5 straight in the playoffs. Were you surprised that Marvin Lewis was given the extension?
I actually was, because he was at the end of his contract, and I thought that that was a natural end point for he and the Bengals, especially since, as you framed it, back-to-back years without the playoffs, back-to-back years of 7-9. But getting the 2-year extension tells me they're ready to rebuild. Retool this team. They've got to get better on the offensive line. They've got to get better skill position players. The defense is going to undergo some more construction now. Got a new defensive coordinator coming in. So the coaching staff, players, a rebuild in Cincinnati, and they think Marvin Lewis is the guy to guide them.
To throw here, Dalton. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. Got a man. It's caught inside the 10. And all the way in for a Cincinnati score. Second touchdown here this first game. And the Bengals are an extra point away from tying up this football game.
Man, hell no. Get the fuck out of here, man.
Back where we started, all even as the kick's away. It's a short kick, taken at the 15.
One band, one sound.
Before the offense changes hands here, let's look back to the Super Bowl, February 5th. What a game.
Tied up 14-14.
Offensively, though, impressive on both sides.
It certainly was, and let's face it, if you're in Minnesota, it's cold outside, but you talk about the offenses, they heated up in a big way. And how about Nick Foles? The backup quarterback turned MVP. 373 yards, 3 touchdowns, and of course, the big one receiving on the Philly special.
Quite a story. As you and I were talking about off air, it
hold
was
on,
just a
fella.
Fluid game. Not a lot of penalties, just really clean play.
Exactly the type of game the NFL needed for the audiences at home watching the game, and of course, people in attendance. A really well played.
What, man? Yeah, this shit nice. That shit nice. Pete, let's go. Yeah, that shit nice, nah. That shit nice, nah. Some ice. That shit nice, nah. Oh shit. Gucci mode. Gucci bandana.
But third MVP this past season, and what he did at age 40, really something, right, Charles?
Absolutely phenomenal. Ended up beating out Todd Gurley, the running back for the Los Angeles Rams. But he would have traded it for a Super Bowl win, don't you think? How about this? The last 9 NFL MVPs to play in the Super Bowl.
And this is caught. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Bengal TD. A big play there.
Oh man, come on, bro.
First half touchdowns, and the Bengals have broken our tie as they take the lead. Bullock out now to kick this one away. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. CD, I want to get your thoughts on some potential free agents this offseason before we change the possession here. Now, caution, many of these guys could be resigned, I know, but who are some of them? Kirk Cousins is one.
Yeah, we're talking about difference makers. Kirk Cousins at the quarterback position, he's going to be coveted around the league by quarterback-needy teams. Case Keenum had a big year. Could he move? But how about running backs? Le'Veon Bell, Deion Lewis. Some pass catchers, Jimmy Graham, Jarvis Landry, Sammy Watkins, and about the guy who goes and gets quarterbacks, DeMarcus Lawrence had a monster year for Dallas last season.
Yeah, a lot of big names. And he'll be taken down by the Bengal pressure.
Scribble man, scribble man.
In from his linebacker spot, he's able to drop it for a loss of about 10. So the sack, and now a third and long situation for the Steelers and Ben Roethlisberger. From the shotgun, it's Roethlisberger.
Pick the fucking ball! Fuck him now! The fuck? The fuck out of here, man! This guy, you a nerd, motherfucker.
That one should have been picked. Look, let's just be honest about it. That would be the second person in his ear because he's hearing it in the huddle right now.
Not the start to the game he wanted. Like you said, the pick on the opening drive, second drive, not much better. we go on fourth down with Roethlisberger.
Pick.
And this is incomplete. What a real head scratcher there. And the Bengals are going to get it back in terrific field position. Before the possession switches here, I had written down that I wanted to talk about some of the awards.
Might be a blowout, fellas.
We know Brady was the MVP, but
he went for it on fourth down. I'm from the school. I got to school now.
Whether he'd had a sophomore slump the season before, didn't even get to 1,000 yards, was a dominant force in 2017. How about his teammate Aaron Donald on the defensive side? He took home Defensive Player of the Year award.
Yeah, very impressive. They had both sides of the
ball. Tight end with the...
deserving, I think you would agree, a coach of the year.
Yeah, definitely.
That man put everybody in coverage. Ain't no way he just got three people.
Scoring, to leading the league in scoring and winning a division.
Really, man.
And how about the New Orleans Saints? Rookie of the Year.
Throw it away.
Offense,
really how you play, man, like a little child doing it, man.
He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it. They had great starting position to begin the drive. And
may have.
Up at a third and five.
Watch
that. From Giovanni Bernard. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11.
No.
It's a pickup of four, but they're still a yard short here with fourth down, forthcoming.
So many things going to making a good play on defense. In this situation, just not being blown out of the way was a big start, and then a nice tackle to finish things off.
They'll try on fourth. Here's Dalton.
Dot.
And he's got his big tight end, Eifert, and it's a Bengal
touchdown. Oh, so.
Tyler Eifert, an 11-yard touchdown, and the Bengals are able to grow their lead.
What they got?
He's got it as they double up the lead. This one's now 28-14. Taken successfully. The Steelers offense now, they head back onto the field. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned into 6 points.
Be cool.
Recover here, Charles.
Don't worry about how I'm ripping.
And the chain of events, right?
This is what I do.
Caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also,
what?
In the defense, they didn't pick up their end of the bargain. So now they get.
Well, back on you down.
And rebuild that confidence.
Over the middle, complete. It's McDowell.
Little iceberg.
He's able to get this one up to the 8-yard line this time. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. On second down, here's Roethlisberger. Throw that shot complete to Smith-Schuster. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25.
I'm gonna help. I don't need all that. That's a guy we braided up him and back.
They'll send Brown in motion lane. Now it's Roethlisberger. Open man right side is Smith-Schuster complete. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. That throw good for four. It's second down.
Oh, my friend, my dude, where the hell are
they? It's me.
You call that dude, Nick?
Yeah.
Turn that shit up a little bit, man.
Big! It's playing low, bro. I don't know what the fuck going on. Fuck it. Goddamn, Pimpy, back!
Go ahead.
Steelers on third down. They've converted three out of five thus far. This will be third and six.
This shit terrible. I don't like this shit. Okay, I'm gonna say it like that. I haven't heard the whole.
As they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one.
So I'm gonna go back and listen to it. But that new goddamn, but that new Lito, I've been on Lito all day today.
In motion left here, Antonio Brown. Now It's McDonald. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
Oh yeah, what I was gonna say. Fuck off what I'm talking about. I forgot the hell I was gonna say. What the hell you going, boy? What the fuck?
Touchdown, Pittsburgh. These two teams in this first half, it's been fun. Back and forth, back and forth. Well, it's not fun for the defensive coordinators, but offensive coordinators are enjoying it.
Yeah, they're having streaks here, aren't they? Being able to put scores together and really bunch them up, and we have a tight game here. You know, we often talk about having the right shoes for the right turf. Today is track shoes.
That's what we well,
yeah, it's been an absolute track meet so far and fun to watch.
Stop the crying, help. I don't need all that. Got a job for your braided up, pimping back. Take the beacon there. Move, fuck. We're going to pay it too, suck.
Boswell on now to kick this one away.
Now, beating the stuff in up. Nice move, love.
Time quickly fading here in the second quarter. Not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Mixon gets the nod to start the drive. Space to maneuver at the 40. Takes it down deep into enemy territory. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play.
Bro, when I see the man running every YouTube play, it don't make no sense.
Second down play. We'll get
I got some for that passing attack. That's all you need to know. You ain't even punt, you fake punt. Then I picked that bullshit off.
Dalton throwing on second down. This will be caught at about the 6. And he will take it on in for a Bengals touchdown.
And that's a lead that excites a team as they head into the half. Good way to finish things off.
Yeah, able to extend that lead. And you
oh!
To totally change the complexion of half number 2.
It
changes your outlook. But even before that, let's see if they decide to kind of squid kick or what they're going to do on the kickoff. Because you don't want to give up a big play.
Damn, man, call a girl back.
Man, get that out of there, bro.
What going on, man? What you doing that for? You must be high.
Got a short kick, taking it about the 16. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the problem.
He's like a ball fan. That bullshit, man.
There's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
They go play action here on first down. Going deep here for Bryant. And this one is incomplete. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. The Bengal offense now with a football first here to begin quarter.
And another one bite the dust.
This is sort of what you would call a putaway.
And another one. And another
here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, but you can take the spirit away from another team, that their drive and will to come back and win can be taken.
Oh, shit.
Third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're cheating right there.
It's
caught inside the 25. And all the way in for a Cincinnati score. A big play there. 77 yards. And the Bengals add on to their lead. Still plenty of time left in the game, but now starting to pull away a little bit, get some breathing room with that one.
And I don't want people to think that NFL locker rooms are cookie cutter, that everyone's saying the exact same thing in every situation, but I do know that all 32 teams have an emphasis on starting fast, game, being on second half no matter what, whether it's first 5 minutes, first three, whatever. This was a big score to start second half.
Bullock out now to kick this one away. This one taken from the 7. Then he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Time for the Steelers offense now to get set for their first possession of half number 2.
They man, I'm up 21.
It's time to touch the ball in quarter 3, and we'll see what they can do.
I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. Now Roethlisberger to throw on second down. This is caught by Antonio Brown. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. The Steelers able to pick up 18 yards there.
What would you have said to me if I told you in pregame that Big Ben and Antonio Brown wouldn't have hooked up until the second half?
I would say that they'd be losing, and they are.
Yeah, they are, and they've got to find a way now to continue to connect and try and get their team back in this game.
And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. 12 more yards there and another first down.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. Chewing up big yardage, another nice gain there. This one goes for 20. On first down, it's Roethlisberger. His throw caught right around the 6. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18.
All right, here we go. Hurry up, let's go. Easy.
Now a first down carry by Bell. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal.
Do you think after that last run, they're thinking to themselves, we had to wait all day to play this night game, and we're still not able to run the ball the way we want to?
Yeah, this defense, they've risen to the challenge all evening long, trying to get it there to Martavis Bryant, and it's third and short.
They may be snapping the ball near the goal line, but all you're thinking defensively, keep them out of the end zone. Force the incompletion, force them into going for 3, and not giving up 6.
Gotta figure this is one they need here on third and goal. Out of the gun, it's Roethlisberger. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. Looked like they had a window to get that in there, but a good job rallying defensively.
Excellent timing. No pass interference. The hit jars it loose. And now they force them into a decision. Do you go for it on fourth down or kick the field goal?
Still just the third quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on fourth.
Shit.
They'll try and throw for him with Roethlisberger. Got his man. It's caught for a Steelers touchdown. Antonio Brown from 3 yards out.
Can I another one? Can I another one?
Able to close the gap just a bit. That's the score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there's an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard, you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
Returning it, John Ross. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. They were able to extend their lead with an opening drive touchdown here in the third quarter, but that just got matched a moment ago.
So we know that what they discussed at the half worked. Now, what are the counters to that, right? You don't just run the same things over and over. Some do, but many will also show something and then come back with something else to keep the defense off balance.
Off the play fake to Mixon. This is Dalton. He's going to rifle one deep left side. That's caught inside the 20. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Bengal TD. A big play there. 72 yards.
Oh, Lord.
Wait, if somebody say.
I don't even know what to say anymore.
Nobody see you later on. Track
of how many times he's been in the end zone. This is just flat unbelievable.
Okay, I'm in work.
Doesn't matter whether you have an abacus, a calculator, just old-fashioned pencil and paper trying to total it up. The number is staggering. What a performance. This man knows how to find the end zone and make it count.
Bullock out now to kick this one away. This is taken at the three. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
Roethlisberger on first down. Over the middle, hauled in by Smith-Schuster. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. The Steelers able to pick up 18 yards there. And he motions the wide receiver. They'll throw on first down with Roethlisberger. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A gain of 10, good for a Steeler first down. And boy, they had high praise for this rookie receiver when we asked the coaches about him, didn't they?
They certainly did, and obviously they liked his measurables, otherwise they wouldn't have brought him onto the team. Height, weight, speed, all of that. But how about what they really said? Competitiveness. That's what they really liked about him. The way he goes after the football, competes.
He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 38, and the possession is theirs at their own 43-yard line.
Ah, Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball, and I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
Man, these DBs are scared.
Their D gets the INT. Now what can Dalton do? To the left side here for Eifert. 18 yards on that one, and the Bengals are moving. First down.
I got the Dalton.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did.
At the end of the day,
on first and 10, here's Andy Dalton. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Brian Allen. And his guys are going to get the football at the 28-yard line. They needed a break. They needed to make a play here in the the third quarter defensively. They did that. Now they got to go quickly and get some points on the board.
And the best part is that they made their own break, taking the ball away. Now they just look at their offense and saying, guys,
let's go.
Come on, capitalize on this one.
They'll try and get the running game going with Bell. And not much. Maybe a yard up to the 29.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage.
Hey, another one like this.
Every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. And boy, that one drops incomplete. But if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble. The Steelers on third down. They've hit 4 and 7. This is third and 9.
Another one.
And he goes in motion here in the backfield. On third down, Roethlisberger. This one complete right side to McDonald. And oh, he is really laid out that time. Knocked flat on his back. They get 7 there, but it brings up 4th.
You play good.
They'll indeed go for it with Roethlisberger. He completes it to Bryant. And he's got a first down as he's up to the 48. It's a Pittsburgh first down, a gain of 13. And passing yardage wise, now up over 350 in this game. Pretty nice performance.
Definitely that, which usually means you're putting a lot of pressure on guys trying to cover. If you're a defensive back and they put over 250 yards on you, you've had a long day. The key to everything, if you're doing it without throwing interceptions or turning the ball over. So this is what happens when you throw interceptions, that confident veneer that you have. It's chipped away a little bit. Maybe a little bit gun-shy throwing it around.
Yeah, under-throwing him there, and you're right. Those interceptions may be in the back of his mind.
Damn, I caught on at the end, bro.
And that's incomplete.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
And the Steelers on third down. They're at 50%, 4-for-8. This
caught
is
on at the motherfucker end, man. Look, this is all good, guy. I'll get your head tomorrow, man.
To throw again is Roethlisberger. And Bryant's got it over the middle. And he's going to have
man,
it.
Man, I'm going to get you. I caught on late. I caught on late.
The passing game in rhythm right now for Pittsburgh. There's another first
man,
down.
Man, I'm getting your route time to develop, bro. I got to send a heat at your head. That's it. Man, I'm feeling that heat at your ass, man.
Man, first down. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Bryant. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just going to ask you, that wasn't the primary target, and he's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that. And that's what he did.
On first and 10, it's Roethlisberger. Over the middle here to Brown. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. That throw good for 4. It's second down.
Advantages
of a passer is now his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle. He can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height.
And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off with great anticipation. And a big turnover there.
Hey, man, that game, man, I'm up 21. And he ain't playing it no more.
Well, this defensive pressure has been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage.
I'm from Phoenix. I need to let my phone charge up. I'm going to text you my food. I'm going to eat.
Just further and further. All
right.
Lead, check, check. And some extras coming up on the line here, ready for the blitz. They'll start here with a give to Mixon. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. They'll get 14 on that one. Good for a Bengal first down.
That gives him 98 yards in this game, and he's going to feel pretty good about that, but the entire offense does. The big thing, though, Brent, they've got to get to 100, though.
You think he knows he's at 98?
I think someone has told him by now, and here's the thing. Getting to 100 or more is tangible evidence that you've had a nice day running the football, and that's what his offensive line wants for him and for themselves.
And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. A Bengal first down on the 16-yard pickup there.
Well, that last run makes this a 100-yard night. I've loved the way he's hit the holes. He's been quick. He's been decisive. And he's been a whole lot of fun to watch.
The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. Dalton on the draw to Mixon. And he'll get this into enemy territory, but not by much as he's down to the 48. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8. And in this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
In motion right here, boy. And out of the air, Dalton. His throw incomplete. He was looking for John Ross that time. And it's third down.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
In motion right here, boy. Here's Dalton. He's going to rifle one deep left side. So they took a shot there on third down, couldn't get it. Now it's 4. Fourth quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charles, you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure you're taking care of the lead, because you keep flinging it around, you throw a couple of picks, you can put yourself in jeopardy.
Hell, he throwing too. I ain't throw that goddamn person.
Marvin Lewis tries for it, but comes up empty. And this defense is going to get the football back near midfield, right at the 48. The Steelers' offense now, they head back onto the field. And with 3 interceptions thrown already, we'll see. Do they rely more on the ground game here?
They may have to change things offensively to try and settle things down, not just for the guy throwing the ball, but for the rest of the offensive unit, because his confidence has to be shaken a little bit. And you just wonder, is the backup going to start to warm up a little bit over on the sideline?
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Over the middle, complete. That's Bryant. That throw good for 4. It's second down. Decent start to the drive, but let's face it, they need a lot of things to go right in a short amount of time, down 3 scores.
Yeah, they're going to run their 2-minute offense here in this game, but this is for future games. Can they get better and be ready for the next time? Hopefully with a chance.
And for the 4th time tonight, it's an interception. William Jackson with a pick, and he brings it back to right around the 26-yard line.
Partner, we always talk about possessions being at a premium in these games, and now in this situation, throwing an interception here when you have to claw your way back in, that one's going to hurt, and in a big way.
In motion right here, Boyd. Now a play fake here on first down. Under heavy pressure and down goes Dalton on the sack. Bud Dupree not dropping into coverage. He comes on the blitz and takes him down for a loss of 9. They'll bring a receiver in motion right. It's second down. Dalton looking. And the catch made. It's Tyler Boyd. And he's brought down after a good game. A good pickup there. 26 yards. And the offense lining up first and 10. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Dalton sets up play action. Going deep downfield for Ross. Man, it's caught at the 6-yard line. And he will take it on in for a Bengals touchdown. A big play there. 57 yards. And the Bengals add on to their lead. Bullock out now to kick this one away. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Time for a break. We'll come back and wrap up garbage time after this. Shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And he's got his man, the tight end, McDonald.